So now I got that open.
What's this? Oh, that's the connective.
That's
tissue,
the
right?
Femur. And that, yeah, that's the ligament that holds it into the socket. So now I kind of have an idea where I'm going. And then this is a great spot for your thumb. And you just gotta ride it out. Now what I mean by this bone being dangerous is that a lot of people tend to do this, and there's nothing to stop the knife from going through. And I know that from many experiences.
Yeah.
But that's definitely, these bones are, boning out hips on lamb is just definitely, because it seems kind of easy, and but there's just, you know, all the next thing you know, you're like, oh. You're waiting on a crossbar, you're like, oh, what else can I get for you?
Oh, God.
Now I want to take some fever out. So, start there. Okay, there's my femur right there. Alright, so I know where it is. And I know it ends right here, right? And I know I'm on that side of it. You always score the bone. If you do that, you really break open the fascia, so you can just, right?
Any bigger bones like that?
Any bone you can do that to. That way people can't say. And then people can't say, like, look at all the meat you left on that. So then what I'll do, and this is just totally my own way. Once I get that open, I'll come up here, here's the patella. A lot of guys leave that on there. A lot of guys will leave this on the boneless leg of lamb and then cut it off later. I like to just take it off now and leave it on the bone, so I don't have to come back to it. So I just swing around the top of it, and that releases that side of the bone. So then I'm pretty much, you know, pretty much out. Now what you got is a boneless leg of lamb. Come around.
You get a boneless leg of lamb, so this is what you would be getting is a boneless leg of lamb.
Is that? A full cut boneless leg of lamb missing, minus the shank.
So you can wrap it back up and close.
You can tie it back up. Now, first thing you want to do before you do anything really with it is, there's a lamb. You gotta take out the sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve right here.
What's it called?
Sciatic nerve.
Sciatic nerve.
And it comes down into the heel. There's this little triangle of fat.
Yeah.
Come on, just take that out. Inside here, there's a gland, which you kind of don't really need to eat. It's a depository of toxins. Yep.
So don't miss that when you're doing this at home.
Yeah, I mean, it probably won't ruin your dinner, but it's a good thing to just get rid of. Alright, so we have our boneless leg of lamb. What we could do is I could come in here and butterfly it, so I can make this muscle flat, and I can make this muscle flat. You can grill it, right? We could leave it like that and tie it up, make a roast. Or we could separate all the muscles out. I might as well go ahead and do that, and I'll just show you guys. So, this one is what you would call a top round. In beef, what they make with these is London broils. Or scallopini. Like veal scallopini is mostly cut from the top round. Yeah. It's a nice
skewer. Veal is like
with these, you kind of see the grain runs this way.
Yeah.
So with these, what you want to do is kind of angle them a little bit. Kind of tips back, and then you can cut them this way. What I like to do with these a lot is I'll square it off. Square off this end. And then what I'll do is I'll come in here in the small end, make a pocket, and then mix up some, like, cook up some spinach and garlic and pine nuts and make a stuffing. Stuff it, split it in half, and then you just throw it on the grill. Those come out really good. Or you can cut it into steaks. It's a nice solid muscle. So that's your top round. Okay, we'll come in here.
See why it's called top round?
Why is
it round?
Why is this called bottom round? This is top round because the fat's on the top. Bottom round because the fat's on the bottom. Okay, so I just learned that about a year ago. Are you serious? Yeah. That's what, you know, it's like you call things a certain thing and finally one day you're like, what is that?
How do you keep track of these regionally but then also internationally? Like, everyone has a different name.
Absolutely. Different cuts. Absolutely. It's definitely interesting. I mean, it's kind of fun.
It's just like the same name for different cuts.
Yeah. Yeah, I get that a lot. So this is your bottom round. This is what, if it was beef, you would mostly find corned beef, right? Or rump roast. You don't see these much anymore in beef, because people don't.
They just grind it up.
Yeah, most of them get ground up these days. So this is your bottom round, eye of the round. Two separate muscles that are connected. I mean, in this you could tie up and make a little roast out of. Or you could take it out, separate it, and make kebabs out of it. It's a nice solid muscle. Then up here we got. Yeah, you can just grill it like that. Absolutely. Any part of this leg, you can just grill it solid. Could this be your sirloin tip or knuckle? Basically, you know, you can split this and cut it into little steaks. For lamb, it makes really good kebabs. It roasts good. It's kind of an in-between mild flavor meat. Here we got, this is the head fillet. This is the top end of the filet mignon, where it runs into the hip. It would eat good, but it's, yeah. You know, you see a lot of lamb tenderloins that come out of New Zealand. They sell, you know, they eat them a lot, but it's the whole tenderloin, so it's, you know, it's smaller than that because their lambs are really young, like 2 months, I think they go.
Really?
Yeah, really young. This. This is going to be your.
Here.
Yep.
So right.
This is basically, this is your top sirloin. That would be your top sirloin steaks. That's gonna be one of the better eating pieces out of that. And then a little more flat meat. And then last but not least, it's the ever-present in California. Tri-tip.
Because you guys stay on the store pushing?
No, you know, the whole idea for tri-tips, back in the 50s, this guy down in down near San Luis, it's a big Paso Robles. This guy down there started making these Santa Maria tri-tips and made this marinade, and they slowly caught on, and then by the early 90s, it was like the rage. So, there's your tri-tip. Like, nobody, I mean, people, like, when they slaughter beef in other states, all the tri-tips come to California. You go to Montana, they don't know what a tri-tip is. It's your bottom sirloin. It's right here.
So this one is?
Yep. And then, top round.
This muscle right here.
Yep. Like that. Sirloin tip is right in here. Tri-tip is underneath here. The bottom round runs up in here. Yeah. Alright, guys.